Hello and welcome to Choral Classics, sung for the last time by this talented 12, great apostles of choral music. Our choral scholars, under the direction of Olivia Tait, our conducting fellow, and accompanied on the organ by Phoebe Tachman-Chow. The theme we've chosen for our music and readings this week is farewell, and over the next 20 minutes we'll explore the painful and positive nature of saying farewell, goodbye. We've just heard Never Weather-Beaten Sail, a lyrical setting of a poem by Thomas Campion, which forms the third of six songs of farewell by Charles Hubert Hastings Parry. Composed towards the end of his life and during the First World War, in which many of his students were killed or injured. The composition is understood as Parry's valedictory wave, a musical farewell not only to his own earthly life, but also to the structures of society, the Europe that he knew. As war wages once again on the continent, this musical plea for God's calming presence upon the chaotic waters of our world seems as necessary now as then. Our next piece is by the Barnsley Nightingale, contemporary singer-songwriter Kate Busby, arranged for choir by Jim Clements. Underneath the Stars describes a farewell between two lovers, meeting for the last time beneath a beautiful starlit sky. As in Parry's song, we encounter the bittersweet nature of farewell at multiple levels. The repeated penultimate refrain that we act under our own free will evokes the memory of the expulsion from Eden. The final enduring words are those of loving kindness. Go gently.
Thank you.
The ultimate farewell, punctuating all life on Earth, death, is the theme for the majority of the published work of the Protestant Irish poet Evangeline Paterson, who died in the year 2000. Her style is not to shield us from the reality of this final goodbye, but rather to face up to it. As Christians, she says, I think death is something we have constantly in our minds, not in any morbid sense. I see death as a tremendously exciting passage into something unbelievably better than we have here. Life wouldn't be complete without it. Deathbed by Evangeline Paterson. Now, when the frail and fine-spun web of mortality gapes and lets slip what we have loved so long, from out our lighted present into the trackless dark we turn, blinded. Not to Christ in glory, stars about his feet, but to the Son of Man, back from the tomb, who built fires, ate fish, spoke with friends, and walked a dusty road at evening. Here, in this room, in this stark and timeless moment, we hear those footsteps. And, with suddenly lifted hearts, acknowledge the irrelevance of death. The revelation that Christ has conquered death, made it irrelevant, is the inspiration for our next piece of music. The beautiful Abendlied, or Evening Song, was written by Josef Rheinberger in 1855 when he was just 15 years old. The text is taken from the description of the appearance of the resurrected Christ to the disciples on that dusty road to Emmaus at evening. Stay with us, because it is almost evening and the day is now nearly over, they said. So he went in to stay with them.
Thank you.
The poet Edward Thomas had a passionate but platonic relationship with the author and hymn writer Eleanor Fargean, which has been immortalized on stage. Offering an alternative perspective to Kate Busby's Go Gently, Thomas's poem Go Now describes a man and a woman parting ways and the lasting effect that her words had on him. As in Rusby's song, the poet cannot separate his love for another from the beauty of the natural world. Like Paterson's poem, Thomas is a realist, concluding that, in terms of our earthly relationships at least, we must accept that sometimes a farewell is forever. The text contains a much-needed reminder to us all never to forget to cherish and value our close relationships. Go Now by Edward Thomas. Like the touch of rain, she was on a man's flesh and hair and eyes. When the joy of walking thus had taken him by surprise, with the love of the storm he burns, he sings, he laughs, well I know how, but forgets when he returns, as I shall not forget her, go now. Those two words shut a door between me and the blessed rain that was never shut before and will not open again. Well, thank you for joining us for Choral Classics. A special thanks to our choral scholars for their beautiful music over the past year. We rely on generous donations from supporters like you to fund our music ministry here. Do make a donation if you're able. There are ways and means of doing so at the door of the church. We're grateful for every donation. Do stay with us for our Choral Eucharist, which begins at 12:45, just a click away if you're watching online. Fantastic music coming up, including a favourite of mine, Vienne's Messa Solennelle. So now it's time for us to bid a fond farewell to Choral Classics for this term and to this year's Choral Scholars. I'll leave this talented 12 to say goodbye in their own special way, performing a golden oldie composed by James Pookie Hudson in 1952, a lament on having to leave his girlfriend, Bonnie Jean, each night after her mother kicked him out onto the street. This choral version has been arranged by Kirby Shaw.